You're listening to GIGI Radio, the one and only Christian radio show for teen girls, with your hosts, Esther and Steph.
It's Wednesday, girls, midweek.
Well, we've been busy doing a couple of things. Oh, I should say hello first.
Hi, girls. Good morning.
How rude. We have been busy getting ready for our GIGI rally.
Yes.
And for the magazine.
Oh, we can say it.
We can say it. And we can't wait for you to have it in your hands.
We hope you've liked the little sneak peek we sent out.
Yes.
And you fell in love with it as much as we did.
It's colorful, bright, it's beautiful. It's got great articles too.
It is. And you've got some things where you do have some writing space and some good ideas and...
Just
yeah,
really
awesome.
Nice.
I want
yeah.
one.
Okay, so a couple of things. Don't forget that we are reading a new verse, and it is Philippians 4:4. Rejoice in the Lord always. I will say again, rejoice. Such a nice one.
I do like that one. That one's a bit more of a reviser, I think, for us.
Yeah.
But I know it, but just, yeah, hadn't said that in a while. So, yeah, it's a nice refresher for us this week.
Yes. Okay, so, what do we have today?
Oh, well, first, challenge reminder.
Oh, yes.
Gratitude journal, girls. Have you been doing your gratitude journal? Are you finding it hard? Is it easy? Are you feeling more grateful? Write
positive.
To us, let us know.
Yeah, let us know.
Now, Esther, we have our Bible archives. Who's in there today? Let's go have a look.
He was born in an obscure village. He was the child of a peasant woman. He grew up in another obscure village, where he worked until he was 30. He never wrote a book. He never held an office. He never went to college. He never visited a big city. He never traveled more than 200 miles from the place he was born. He did none of the things usually associated with greatness. He had no credentials. He was only 33 years old when he died. He was nailed to a cross between two thieves. He laid in a borrowed grave. And he rose again 3 days after.
Girls, I'm not even going to give you time to think. We all know it's a Jesus. I love that one. So I actually want you girls to turn with me. And I've decided that for Bible Archives text, I'm going to read John 3:16 and 17. And it says, "For God so loved the world that he gave his one and only Son, that whoever believes in him shall not perish but have eternal life. For God did not send his Son into the world to condemn the world, but to save the world through him."
I love it. I love the story of Jesus so
we
much.
Love Jesus. Yeah. He's just beautiful.
The more you get to know Jesus, girls, maybe he's not, sometimes you might feel that he's not real. But the more you get to spend time with him in your mornings, in your devotionals, in praying throughout the day, you don't have to kneel to pray and talk to him. You can just chat with him in your mind.
Mm-hmm.
The more you will honestly fall in love with him. But you've got to try it because he is just amazing.
Read those the books, the New Testament, Matthew, Mark, Luke and John, where it is about him and his ministry. And you can't help but fall in love with a God full of love who just came to help and save. So it's up to us if we want to accept him or not. So girls, let's get into our devotional for this morning.
Today's devotional is written by Scott Higgins. I won't be back. A high school girl wrote the following letter to a friend. I attended your church today. Although you had invited me, you were not there. I looked for you, hoping to sit with you. I sat alone. A stranger. I wanted to sit near the back of the church, but those rows were all packed with regular attenders. An usher took me to the front. I felt as though I was on parade. During the singing of the hymns, I was surprised to note that some of the church people weren't singing. Between the sighs and yawns, they just stared into space. Three of the kids that I had respected on campus were whispering to one another throughout the whole service. Another girl was giggling. I really didn't expect that in your church. The pastor's sermon was very interesting, although some members of the choir didn't seem to think so. They looked bored and restless. One kept smiling at someone in the congregation. There were several people who left and then came back during the sermon. I thought, how rude. I could hear the constant shuffling of feet and doors opening and closing. The pastor spoke about the reality of faith. The message got to me and I made up my mind to speak to someone about it after the service. But utter chaos reigned around the benediction. I said good morning to one couple, but the response was less than cordial. I looked for some teens with whom I could discuss the sermon, but they were all huddled in a corner talking about the newest music group. My parents don't go to church. I came alone, hoping to find a place to truly worship and feel some love. I'm sorry, but I didn't find it in your church. I won't be back.
Wow, that is quite heavy.
It is. You know what? When I was reading it, I was like, oh, yes, we do that sometimes.
We do that. Like, I could see a few churches I visited that do that.
Mm.
How shameful.
Yes. Ooh. Well, we'll discuss it after this song, which is a song by Kari Jobe, and it's called Find You on My Knees.
Troubles chasing me again, breaking down my best defense. I'm looking, God, I'm looking for you. Weary just won't let me rest, and fear is filling up my head. I'm longing, God, I'm longing for you. But I will find.
Thinking about that story.
No. So, girls, when you go to church, how are people seeing you? How are visitors seeing you? Are we giving like a good impression or are we not?
Yeah. You know, I'm thinking about a time when I went to church and it's happened to like a few friends I know, which luckily if I wasn't already a Christian, this might turn me off. But I went and I sat down at a church pew and this actually man came up to me and goes, excuse me, you're in my chair. was like, are you kidding me? I'm like, okay, sure, whatever. So I moved. I was like, how rude. If I was a visitor, I'd be like, well, keep your chair and your church. I'm not coming back.
But we have been back and we don't care.
No, we don't, because like we're not there for people, but someone coming out of, like, I guess,
coming for the first time, yeah, and they don't know Jesus yet.
They need to see the kindness and the difference, not be exactly the same as, you know, elsewhere.
Yes. So girls, if there's a new girl at your church about your age, go and say hello. You know, just say, hello, welcome to our church. We hope you had a great time. You don't need to be best friends straight away, but you can be nice.
Yeah,
and you can
be important. Kind. Yeah.
I think it's important. The other thing is, sometimes maybe we are the ones going through this. Maybe we are the ones that are feeling really neglected by our church.
Mm.
We are, you know, feeling that you're not happy there. And I think sometimes you have to evaluate and see, why am I not happy in church or at that church? What is happening? And if you're really not happy and you want to change, find a church where you get involved and where you are going to be happy, because that's important.
And when you have the same values that they, like, you share the same values, maybe you're like helping, you know, food kitchen things, and that other church might have it. So, yeah, find another church. Don't leave church.
That's
find
not the
a
solution.
New one. It is not the solution.
Yes, it's going to be, you're going to be better off finding a new church than getting out of church completely.
Yeah.
And your eyes have to be so focused on God. It's really important that your eyes are on Him and not what everybody else is doing.
Oh, yeah. People will always disappoint. And believe me, people from church, unfortunately, even though we think we might be perfect, are very, 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 very far from it. And sometimes people outside the church are more genuine than us, which is really sad.
Mm.
So don't look at people. Look at God.
And we're all fighting for the same thing. Yeah. We're all trying.
Yeah, for sure.
Okay, so I thought that was a beautiful devotional and a great thing to get us thinking.
I can't stop thinking about it.
I know. So I'd like to share a poem, what we talked about Jesus before in our archives. And it's a beautiful poem. I love the words. It's simple. It's beautiful. But here's the one that we have to keep our eyes on.
One Solitary Life, written by Dr. James Allen, 1926. He was born in an obscure village, the child of a peasant woman. He grew up in another obscure village, where he worked in a carpenter shop until he was 30. He never wrote a book, he never held an office, he never went to college, he never visited a big city. He never travelled more than 200 miles from the place where he was born. He did none of the things usually associated with greatness. He had no credentials but himself. He was only 33. His friends ran away. One denied him. He was turned over to his enemies and went through the mockery of a trial. He was nailed to a cross between two thieves. While dying, his executioners gambled for his clothing, the only property he had on earth. When he was dead, he was laid in a borrowed grave through the pity of a friend. 19 centuries have come and gone, and today, Jesus is a central figure of the human race and the leader of mankind's progress. All the armies that have ever marched, all the navies that have ever sailed, all the parliaments that have ever sat, all the kings that have ever reigned put together have not affected the life of mankind on earth as powerfully as that one solitary life.
Let's pray. Dear Jesus, it's so beautiful to read everything you've done for us, but it's more beautiful to feel you close to us, to give us that peace that only you can give. Thank you that we have a way to communicate with you, to talk to you, to spend time with you. I ask today a special prayer for the girls listening to this. If they haven't committed to spending time with you, may you open their hearts so that they can find you and they can experience the peace that only you can give. In your name I ask, amen.
This has been GIGI Radio signing out.